Did I? How do we find strength to love ourselves?
The question was, how do we find the strength to love ourselves?
The strength is there. A young person always has a lot of strength in him or her. According to the Buddha, which is one of us, because the Buddha is a human being, he's a child of the earth. He grew up and he asked very much the same question. He saw suffering around him and in him. And that is why he saw that love is the only way to remove suffering. So his question is very much the same. So when you see suffering around you, and inside of you, you might be motivated by the desire to be something, to be someone, to do something in order to reduce that suffering, to bring well-being into the world. And that is the teaching of the Four Noble Truths. The first one is the existence of suffering, of ill being. And that is so easy to see. Suffering is around us and inside of us. And if you try to run away from suffering, and then you have no chance. That is why you have to acknowledge suffering as existing and try to have a look. You ask the question as why people suffer like that. Why you suffer like that? So there is a curiosity in you, and if you are really interested, you will focus your attention on suffering and you will find out how suffering has been made. And out of that kind of reflection, insight will come. You will understand. And when you understand suffering, you can also see the path that lead to happiness, to the cessation of suffering. So the strength may come from your remark, your awareness that suffering is there. The strength may come from your curiosity, your desire to understand why suffering is, why suffering has come like that. And you know that in order to understand the suffering around, you have to understand the suffering inside. Because the suffering inside may reflect the collective suffering. The suffering of the earth, the suffering of humanity and other species. Yes. When we look deeply into one thing, we can see many things. So that is what the Buddha suggested, that we look deeply into our own suffering. And he asked the question about the making of that suffering, why that suffering has come to you, and how the suffering reflects the suffering of the world. So that kind of curiosity, that kind of practice of looking deeply is already the strength the energy. In Buddhism, we call it awareness, mindfulness, concentration. We are aware of the suffering. We are mindful of suffering. We focus our attention on the suffering, trying to understand. And that is the strength. And with that kind of strength of mindfulness and concentration, we make a breakthrough, we begin to understand. And understanding is only love. In the teaching of the Buddha, if you don't understand, you cannot love. So understanding is already love. When you understand yourself, your suffering, you love yourself. And when you love yourself, you know how to love other people and make them stop suffering. So we can see that kind of strength as energy of love. And it is in mindfulness and concentration. It's so clear. When I understand my suffering, I love myself. And I know how not to keep nourishing that suffering, how to transform that suffering. I get lighter, I get compassion, I become more compassionate. And with that kind of freedom and compassion, I feel much better. I feel liberated. And with that, I am in position to help others to do the same. And that is the practice of love. We have studied the five mindfulness trainings. And they are not commandments made by someone, a God. But that is the fruit, the five mindfulness trainings, the fruit of mindfulness and concentration. We look around and we see suffering, and we see the cause of suffering. And out of that kind of insight, we see the five mindfulness training is the path that can transform suffering and can bring well-being. And those of us who have received the trainings, we know that that is the path of love. And love is a tremendous kind of energy that can transform self and others. If you have enough awareness, if you are curious enough to look at your own suffering, you have already enough strength to love yourself. And you know that to love yourself is to love the world. There is no difference. Look at the tree standing outside. A tree has to be healthy, beautiful. And a tree has to take care of itself so that it is robust enough, healthy enough, beautiful enough. If a tree is less than a tree, and then all of us will get into trouble. That is why it's very important that the tree is a real tree, healthy. So when we love yourself, we love ourselves. We have the whole world for profit. That is why loving oneself and taking good care of oneself, you love the world and take care of the world. Look at the tree, the message is very clear. Imagine a tree is less than a tree. Everyone will be in trouble. That is why a tree should practice in order to be a real, beautiful, healthy tree. And each of us is like a tree. We have to take care of ourselves. We show our love to our father and mother in us, our ancestors in us, and the world, because the whole cosmos have come together in order to produce leave us. So we carry the whole world inside. And that is why to accept ourselves and to love ourselves is an expression of gratitude. Okay.